Friends, and welcome to this ASMR scalp check and treatment with me, ASMR Treasury, and my lovely assistant here, Poppy. Today we are going to be checking through Poppy's scalp to see what condition it's in. And we are going to be applying any treatments that are required. And we will also finish with a lovely, relaxing scalp massage. Just to make sure Poppy is as relaxed as possible at the end of the treatment. Okay. So we are going to begin by brushing through Poppy's hair before we have a look at its condition. We want to make sure that the hair is not at all tangled, so that nothing we do is uncomfortable. I have a lovely detangling brush here. I'm going to start at the front of Poppy's hair. Work down through the length on either side. As well from the front to back over the crown of the head. Poppy is very lucky to have such lovely long hair. And it's a really beautiful. Removed all of the tangles from your hair there. So I'm just going to move on now to looking at your hair itself before we begin looking at the scalp. So sign of healthy hair. It's not stretchy. And if we take a look at the ends quickly, you lovely shine to it. It's not at all dull. It seems to be in really good condition. There's a rainstorm here tonight. Are you enjoying the sounds of the rain? Good. Okay. I am happy with the condition of Poppy's hair. So we won't need you to tilt your head back slightly, that's it, and I'm going to shine a little light just onto your parting line there so I can begin to have a look at the skin on your scalp. Very good. Okay. So we're just looking for any areas of dryness. Any broken skin, damage, or anything that might indicate there are issues with the scalp. Has your head been itchy at all lately? No? Been feeling dry or sensitive? No? Okay. Let's begin to section the hair then. So I'm just going to use some chopsticks for this. I'm going to section your hair and take a look at different start here on this left side, just moving the hair out of the way and having a look there at the visible scalp. To see how the skin responds. Let's have a look over here. Moving around to the back. The nape of your neck. here. Some shampoos contain silicones as well, which can build up in the hair. Just working now through the right side of your head. Through your hair before we move on to the next section. Okay. Just to ensure that it is that natural parting line again. Okay. How's that feeling? Good. Very good. Okay. I'm going to move on now to checking the oil levels on the scalp. So it is natural that skin produces a certain amount of oils and sebum throughout the day. It's protective barrier, but there shouldn't be an excess of it. So, did you wash your hair today? Yeah, your hair's been washed today. Okay. And do you normally have to wash it every day? Sometimes you have to wash it every day. Okay. How many days can you go between washes before your hair gets greasy normally? Oils more quickly. Some people with very fine hair, like me, tend to need to wash their hair more frequently because the oils show up more. So let's have a quick look and see if there's any excess oil on the skin there. Okay. So I just have this sheet here. It's a very thin sheet, and it will just show us if there are any oils on the skin. So I'm going to take this and press it onto your scalp. And hold it up to the light to see if it has picked up any oils. To check also at the hairline around the ears. Is to be in a very good condition as it stands. The best thing that we can do is actually just protect it. We want Use that brush to work them into the skin. Good, that's it. Down onto the right side of your head. I'm going to create a path. Same serum just in two places there, so that we can then work it into the skin on this right side. going to use a Scalp Love Leave-In Tonic. And this is just going to help to protect the scalp from day-to-day pollutants in the air, things like that. From any products that are used in the hair, hairsprays and such things. And it's going to help to reduce any sensitivity in the scalp or any redness. So I'm going to apply a few pumps of this and then I'm going to massage it onto the scalp. So I'm going to start on this side here. Just a couple of sprays. Slightly further down, a couple more. slow, deep breaths in through the nose and out through the mouth. One of these, it's a great way to be able to give yourself a scalp massage at home. Use this final tool, which is a silicone scalp massager, which is really going to help to work that product in. Okay, just starting from the parting line, working down towards the nape of the neck. brush through your hair, but I'm going to start at the bottom this time so we can work out any tangles we've created from the bottom back up towards the parting line. you, my friends, for coming to see me today. And also, thank you to Poppy for being such a wonderful assistant. I hope to see you again very soon.